Three sessions ago, we read a letter from a woman who complained that she was always attracting the same kind of men into her life, men who used her. All her boyfriends and husbands were men who moved in with her and then used her for money, sex, and whatever else they could get out of her. I suggested to her that we're all attracted to a certain combination or soup, if you like, of imitation love. And we, in turn, attract people to us who like the particular soup of imitation love that we have to offer. Almost all relationships are based on a trade of imitation love. This woman was advertising, almost entirely unconsciously to men, that she was willing to be used. And there were many men only too glad to do that. But then the imitation love wears off, and everyone gets very disappointed, even bitter. So back to her. What can you do to change this pattern in your life, this pattern that's just killing you? A lot. The first step is to realize what you're doing. Once you understand how you keep attracting these men, you can begin to make different choices. But that's mostly an intellectual step, and it's rarely enough. The real solution is to address the cause of your behavior. The only reason you fall for the exchange of imitation love with men is that you don't have enough real love. And in your emptiness, imitation love is all you have to eliminate the pain in your life. So the solution is obvious. You need more real love. You need to tell the truth about yourself to people who can then love you unconditionally. Preferably, tell the truth to other women, because you don't need the distraction of even the slightest hint of sexual attraction. Finding and feeling real love is hard enough without adding that distraction. So don't. Share the Real Love Book with other women. When you find some who are interested in the principles, form a Real Love Book Club, for example. Then tell the truth about yourself with these friends. Do it in regular real love groups. Do it on the phone every day with someone. Do whatever it takes to be filled with this critical element. Because when you are filled with real love, everything begins to change. You lose your emptiness and fear. You become whole and happy. And in that condition, you won't need a man desperately. Then you simply won't put out all those signs to men that you're willing to be used. You really won't. I've seen this work with women over and over again, and with men. So when you stop putting out the signs that you're willing to be used, the kind of man who would use women will simply not be attracted to you. No kidding. He'll go somewhere else. He'll naturally be attracted to the women who do put out those signs. Now, what if, on some freakish chance, a man prone to use women did begin a relationship with you? You wouldn't put up with it for a moment. Why? Because once you know what real love is, you won't settle for imitation anymore. Get more real love in your life, my dear. I mean it. That's the most important thing you can do. And the entire pattern of your life will change. And it can become pretty fantastic. Why? Because it's always about real love.